What's up? It's Stacy. Hey, I had a couple things on my heart and on my mind for honestly the last couple weeks, and I wanted to share some insight that God has been working in my soul and doing through me because I think you may be able to relate. So I got my Starbucks, I did my workout, I spray tan last night to cover up the pimples on my chin because maybe too much cheese, I'm not sure. But I wanted to share this because I think you can relate. And I just finished reading the book Girl Wash Your Face by Rachel Hollis. She's so awesome. If you don't follow her on Instagram, you need to. And she was talking about the power of me too. And I loved when she said that in the book because there's so often that we can feel alone as moms and we're in our houses, we're with our kids, it's summer, we're overwhelmed, we've got a ton of things on our to-do list. And some days we get like one thing done, right? And then we pop on to Instagram stories or wherever your favorite outlet is, like Pinterest or wherever you like to go to just chillax for a second. And then it hits and it's like, her life looks pretty perfect. Wow, I wonder if she ever eats chips at 11 o'clock at night, or I wonder if she ever has a bad hair day or whatever it is. And like, all of a sudden, these mean girl thoughts, which that's another book, by the way, Mastering Your Inner Mean Girl. I've read that one as well. Obviously, I have issues, which is why I'm talking about this. But I think comparison, we've heard it a million times, comparison steals our joy. And there's a couple things I wanted to share with you that I heard. I heard a sermon the other day about it. And just by listening to the audiobooks like Girl Wash Your Face and different things. I've got a couple things that I think will help you because it's great for me to learn and for me to take in this information, but I feel like if I'm not sharing it, then I'm not walking out my calling and walking out purpose in this life, and it just kind of all just internalizes, and I don't like that feeling. I really like the feeling of giving and sharing. So when I think about the comparison game, and there was honestly two people that I had to unfollow this year because I found myself totally comparing because we had enough similarities to where I compared to them. And then I just felt like I didn't measure up. Like on the measuring stick, I was like, holy crap, I suck. Like, how are they doing so many great things? Like we all have 24 hours in a day, but what's going on? And like, I had to unfollow them. And sometimes I'll go back and look at them because I love them. Like they inspire the crap out of me. I don't know if you've heard this, but it was something I heard at our coach summit this year, and it was basically like, go where you're envious. You know what I mean? Like level up. See the things that you want and figure out a way to get them and figure out a way to have your life and your priorities look the way that you want them to by taking action, right? And by just setting the priorities up. So Matt and I, my husband, he used to be in real estate. I'll tell you this quick story because that's kind of what got me thinking about this subject. He was in real estate when my daughter was born in 2010, when our daughter was born. He's not a baby daddy, he's her daddy. Sorry. Sorry. I think I'm funny sometimes and I do laugh at my own jokes, but whatever. So we went on a walk. We live by the water. We live in a really pretty state, or well, we live in Washington, but we live in a really, really pretty place where we can walk to the water quickly. And he was like talking to me about, because he got out of real estate around that time she was born. And he was like, you know, the market's really good right now. He has a lot of friends that are still in real estate. And he's like, dang, I should have never got out of real estate. What was I thinking? What is God doing? Why are we struggling right now with this, and this, different things? And he's like talking about specific people, and he knows how many homes they closed this month. Like he's a numbers guy, he's a finance guy. I am not a numbers person. I will forget. I know my birthday. You know what I mean? Like, so he was like, well, he closed six houses this month, and so that means XXX. And he's like literally rattling off these numbers. He's like a human calculator. And I was like, babe, you know what? Like, I had to pause. I listened, right? Because I'm 40 now, so I'm smart. I listen more than I talk. I try to. And I was like, babe, I honestly feel like you should unfollow the top people that are kind of giving you that feeling in your spirit about the real estate. Because obviously God didn't call you to real estate right now. He's called you to where you're at. And as uncomfortable as it can be, I don't really think God's worried about our comfort. I think he's more worried about our character growth and development and trusting him. And so it was kind of crazy because he was like, yeah, I think you're right. I think I'm going to unfollow these, you know, few people that it's just been, I just can't, every time I look, I just can't. And so I want you to know, and he, like, the next morning he came to me, he was like, thank you. I feel so free now. And I was like, babe, I'm so happy for you because I don't want you to feel like you're not measuring up or you're not where you're supposed to be, because you're exactly where you're supposed to be if you have peace in your soul. It doesn't matter what your paychecks look like right now. That's going to come. You know, we really, he has taught me, because he comes from a family of entrepreneurs, he gives more than 10%. Like we give, I keep making it like we're not together. We're married. We've been married for 12 years. So he comes from a place of abundance. He's like, God's going to provide. We give more than we should. We give. And I love that about his spirit, because he's never worried about it. We don't live paycheck to paycheck because of my coaching business, which makes it nice. I've been able to supplement our family's income during these hard times, and it's a huge, huge, huge blessing. And so I do want to just give you, so that's kind of the story that got this started, but here's some things that I heard during the sermon that really hit home with me. And if this helps you, please like share this or comment if you've struggled with this at all, because, you know, me too, like we're in this together. We're not alone in these struggles that we deal with as humans. We all have similar tendencies, right? And so the pastor was saying, like, instead of looking at like who you're not, look at who you are and really think about that and try to shift your perspective. He was also saying, I have little notes on my board. I think a lot of times I've noticed, especially because I just did a ropes course with some friends for my birthday, and trust is a really, really, really big thing with us, with people, with humans, right? And especially I think with women too. And there is a lack of trust that we have in our daily lives. I think if we really were to focus on it, we'd be like, dang, yeah, I just don't trust nothing. I don't trust my lanyard. It's not going to hold me up on this ropes course. I was like hovering above the ground and about to die. I don't trust, you know, this person, or I don't trust this program. Like, you know, I'm in health and fitness. So it's like, well, I've just spent a bajillion dollars on nutritional shakes and workouts and none of it's worked, right? Why would I trust your plan just because it worked for you? It's not going to work for me. Like, there's definitely a lack of trust that I see in people. And it's interesting to me because I forget that I have that same amount. And I kind of, at this point, I'm like, why would you ever not trust this? This obviously works. It's great. Just invest in yourself, you know? But it's just that it's, you have to see the value in it before you're going to put your money on something and trust it. So like when it comes to your calling, when it comes to like not comparing yourself and just really being content with where you're at, it's looking at, like, instead of questioning it and not trusting, just start taking action. Start doing where you're at, start where you're at, wherever you are today, you know, start. And then also the next thing that I think about is, and I've seen it a million times over, you'll see confirmation on the path. You won't see it when you're being asked to move and have faith. You'll see it as you move and as you go along the path, when in your business, in your health and fitness, in your parenting. You've got to just keep going one foot in front of the other. And this is all reminders to me, right? So the pastor was saying, like, okay, well, if you've got your measuring stick and you measure it and you look at the hard circumstances, I mean, in any business, like, cause I, with our coaching team, with our coaching business, it takes a lot of trust and, walking by faith and not by sight sometimes in the end goal and the end things that can happen. And so, when you measure the hard circumstances and it's just so much easier to quit, right? Because you're like, this is just too hard. Well, any job, like I always think, I'm like, if I'm complaining about my work, I'm like, every job has a shit sandwich you have to eat. Like, it's never perfect. It's work. That's why it's called work, right? And so I just have to really go, okay, well, what am I worried about? Like, don't measure, or even your hard circumstances, not even in just in business, like in life. So if you're looking at it with a measuring stick, then it's way easier to quit. If you're looking at it by getting on the scale and really listening to who your creator called you to be, called you where you're at. You get on the scale, you look at all the faithfulness that's happened, that he's provided in your life and shown up for you, and things he's probably saved you from that you don't even know. You know, there's so many things that I think his protection has covered my life and I don't even know what that is. And so I can have faith for the future because I'm getting on the scale and I'm listening to who he says that I am, and I can trust that and be confident in that and know that he's gonna close doors and open doors as I need them. And I don't need to know the whole story. I don't need to see the future. I just need to focus on today, and tomorrow will worry about itself. And so I think that with Matt and I, with, you know, being able to just hit the unfollow button and be like, yeah, I can follow them again when I feel like maybe my emotional health is a little bit better in this one area, and when I can feel disciplined with putting my blinders on and focusing on what God has for me instead of looking at what everybody else's life looks like. Because if you think about a horse race, you think about those horses, they have blinders on their faces for a reason, because they are running their race. They are not supposed to be looking at the horses next to them and getting caught up on how fast they're going, because it's not about the speed, it's about the destination, and it's about knowing and feeling a peace with where you're called. And so this for me has been huge lately, because I can feel defeated so quickly with some different circumstances that have been handed to me. And so I just, it was really cool for Matt and I to bond on that, my husband and I, and think about your blinders, just put your blinders on and do it that way. I think that was all I had for you guys today. Just remember, you can unfollow for a hot second, you know, and just remember to, like, every morning I wake up before the kids and I drink my Energize and I work out and I connect with my mind and my body, and I'm not perfect. Some days I don't read my Bible. Some days I sit and I watch Instagram stories instead. And you know what? God's grace can cover that too, because no one's supposed to be rigorously perfect every day. I don't think that's how we're made. We're made to be creative and free and, you know, get those flows of creativity that happen, and then sometimes the funk happens and you just got to deal with all of it. And I think that balance is a hard part of life. As I'm raising two children, I'm like, they're going to have to learn that balance. And it's like every day a new struggle for me to learn that balance and figure out what actions need to line up with what priorities in my day, and how I do that and how I'm present for all of the people that need me and that I love. So I hope this helped. I just hope you guys have a fantastic day. I'm going to finish my coffee. And if you want to check out my Instagram stories, I'm actually going to be showcasing some of the things I got on the anniversary sale, because I just turned 40, right? So it's my birthday. So all I asked for was money. I was like, all I want is money for the Nordstrom anniversary sale. So I'm going to show you guys what I got. And big hugs and kisses to all you women and mamas out there.